Good afternoon. This is Jim Lakey with news and announcements for Maxville and St. John, Kansas, on cable channel 3 and sandylandcenter.org, our website. And so we do invite people to look at the website if you missed the news, and that'll be there along with commissioners meetings and city council meetings and all kinds of other good information. So sandylandcenter.org is a good place to go to find out lots of things. You can watch the community bulletin board there too if you don't have cable, and that way you can keep up to date on what happens in the town and whose birthday it is. So today is Wednesday, the 20th of July. It's 95 degrees at noon time, and we're having a sunny day today, and the temperature's going to be 107, they're predicting. And that kind of falls in line with how hot it's been. Then, on Thursday, we're supposed to have isolated thunderstorms, a temperature high of 105, and the thunderstorms right now are most likely in the late afternoon tomorrow. And for those of you who are people who pray, I think it would be a good idea if all of us would pray for some rain. We don't need a flood or a tornado, but it would be nice to have a good rain of a couple inches. So if you're somebody who prays, pray that as the storm goes by, it doesn't miss us, and that we will have an inch or two of rain, and that no lightning strikes or tornadoes. Then on Friday, sunny, 104. Saturday, sunny, 103. Sunday, partly cloudy, 101. And Monday, partly cloudy, and 100. And if the temperature keeps going down 1 degree every day, in 3 or 4 months, it'll be cool. So it's really hard to deal with temperatures over 105, for sure. Now, since we only are doing the news in the summer on Wednesday, we have a lot of birthdays. So today, happy birthday to Nathan Wood and Ramsey McVeigh. None tomorrow. On Friday, happy birthday Marlene Warnke. None on Saturday. On Sunday, Mackenzie Kirby, happy birthday. And on Monday, Joanne Massey and Max Zimmerman, happy birthday. And next Wednesday, Brenna Martin and Everett and Joe Carroll Hudson have an anniversary on a week away on Tuesday. And we have none for next week on Wednesday. And so those are the birthdays. Now we're in the midst of the United Methodist Church having its Bible school. And so for the next 3 days, until the 22nd is the last day, they're having the Shake It Up Cafe, and it's at the Methodist Church from 6 to 8 p.m. And even if you haven't been there already, you could still go and register at the meeting, and they would be just as glad to see you as the people who've been there all along. So another Bible school opportunity for our folks at the Methodist Church for the rest of the week. Because the air conditioner and some other things were not working right with the city bus, some things are being canceled. And one thing that's canceled is July 23rd, pizza and a movie at Elroy's. And another thing is the 27th of July, the casino trip at Dodge City is also canceled. And you certainly want the bus to be in good shape if you're going to go out of town on a trip like that. You don't want it to break down, and you can't imagine how much fun it is if the air conditioner isn't working. But I think they have the air conditioner fixed, and they have some other things to fix so that they can be sure that the bus is in top condition and nobody will be stuck out on the road somewhere in this kind of temperatures that we're having. The menu that I have is for our friends in Maxville at the VIP Center. Today they're having tuna salad. Tomorrow, pork brisket. Friday, sausage and gravy. Monday, baked fish. Tuesday, Swiss steak. And next Wednesday, barbecued pork. And if you're a senior in Maxville and you don't go to the fellowship meal there at the VIP Center, you're really missing out on some good food and probably a chance to get to say hello to some old friends and neighbors. Well, I had, two things. One is that the county commissioners meeting will be after this broadcast, and so you should stay tuned. And if it's ready, I know they had a lot of executive sessions, so I'm not sure how long the county commissioners meeting is going to be. But that's good. It makes it easier to watch because you get to skip the executive sessions. Anyway, the last item, if you remember, I was telling you about last week what to do if the electricity goes off, and I have something new to add that I didn't think of. And I got that from listening to the city council meeting last night. But if the electricity goes off and we try to come on with city power and the temperature is up in the hundreds, everybody's air conditioning is going to be running. And so when they get things ready and the generators are getting warmed up and all, and they start to put the city back on our own electricity, if everything is running everywhere, a lot of times the generator just can't begin with a surge load like that, and it will make the generator shut down and they have to start over again. So if the electricity goes off, you can get it back on a lot faster if you do things like turn off your air conditioner unit. And I would turn off my computer because if it flickers back and forth, it might blow out your computer. But turn off any electrical things, especially things that use a lot of electricity. And the one item that I forgot or I didn't realize is that if you're watering your lawn with city water, and everybody might be doing that with a sprinkler system, watering their lawn with city water, then the city wells use a lot of electricity to keep up with the demand for water. And so one of the things you want to do along with the air conditioner is to turn off your lawn sprinkler too. Now, you can leave on, it's a good idea, maybe some light somewhere or radio turned on so that when the electricity comes back, you know about it. And then you can wait maybe 5 or 6 minutes and start turning things back on. And that will help because the amount of electricity we're using now is almost more than the city can generate with all its generators when we're in a big demand day like we're going to be in today or any other day. And so that's kind of what happened on the Saturdays. The regular transmission lines blew out and we lost power. But we had a real hard time trying to take that load with the city because every time they tried to turn it on, there were so many things drawing electricity that it would automatically shut down rather than blow itself up. So it really helps if you turn off everything and it's a hot day like that. If we were in the winter, it wouldn't make that much difference because, you know, we're not running many air conditioners in the winter or watering lawns. So anyway, that would help the city to get our electricity back on when the main power system gets blown out and we have to go to our own generation. Well, that's most of the news that I have for you. And the word of the day is this. Don't ask God for what you think is good. Ask God for what he thinks is good for you. And of course, while you're at it, you might put in a word or two about some rain that we really need here. So if everybody prayed for rain, at least we'd be doing all we could to help influence the weather. Well, this is Jim Lakey with the news, and I appreciate your watching.